Kissimmee on different breaking news just 3 miles away when that plane went down. WESH 2's chopper Dan McCarthy actually heard other pilots on his headset talking about that very plane just before it crashed short of the runway. He has this expert take on the deadly crash.
Yeah, Martha, Jim, right now talking with the control tower here at Kissimmee Airport. The aircraft here was doing what they call touch and go, just touching down on the runway, taking off, coming around, doing basically pattern work, also talking to other pilots in the area that witnessed the pilot. This is some kind of old fighter jet trainer, I believe, from Europe. The tower told me that was called a Fuga, F-U-G-A jet. That was the type of jet here. You could see it had some kind of malfunction, but they were doing very aggressive touch and goes from other pilots in the area. I heard them talking about how he was making steep bank turns to the runway, runway 24. As a matter of fact, if we pan the camera to the left, you can see they're only a couple hundred feet short of the runway. They planned this one a little bit too tight, lost the altitude. In a jet, when you turn tight, that's when you're going to lose most of your altitude. And clearly, unfortunately, that's what happened here. We just cut it a little bit too tight and probably 400 or 500 feet short of the runway. Right now, no official word, but we are seeing fire rescue on scene. Not sure if anyone is able to escape it. They had ejection seats. Unfortunately, we are seeing some sheets on the ground here, so not a good indication of the outcome of the two pilots on this aircraft. Of course, as we get more information, we'll pass it on. Reporter for the Western News team, Sharpton and McCarthy in the high definition.